The Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, or SNAP, is administered by FNS, the Food and Nutrition Service of the U.S. Department of Agriculture. FNS authorizes qualified retailers to accept SNAP benefits and strictly enforces program rules to prevent errors and abuse. This video is intended for retailers who have already applied for or have been authorized to accept SNAP benefits. It provides an overview of eligible purchases, what is allowed and not allowed, the consequences that you might face if you break the rules, and how to prepare your store and staff for success. Please view the other videos in the training series and read the associated training guide. How can I prepare my store and staff to accept SNAP benefits? Train everyone who works in your store. Participating in SNAP can be an important part of your business, but program violations are costly. As an authorized store owner or manager, you are legally responsible for your actions and the actions of everyone who works in your store, whether they are paid or not. If you or anyone working in your store breaks a program rule, you could lose your SNAP permit, be fined, and be subject to criminal prosecution. When you applied to accept SNAP benefits, you agreed to train everyone working in your store. Use this training series and the associated guide to educate everyone who works in your store. You must be able to demonstrate that an established compliance program and policy is in place at your store to prevent SNAP violations from occurring. At a minimum, an acceptable SNAP training program has three parts. 1. SNAP training within 30 days of employment for each person. 2. Annual SNAP training for everyone. 3. Ongoing review of program rules and guidance, such as this video. Documentation for both the initial and refresher training must include a record of the materials reviewed, name of the owners and employees, date of employment, date of training, and signatures of the owners and employees attesting to their SNAP training. Ongoing review of program rules and FNS training materials. When changes in the program are announced by FNS, you should ensure that everyone learns them. The program rules, SNAP training guide for retailers, and this training series can be found online at www.fns.usda.gov/snap. Respect your SNAP customers. You must treat SNAP customers the same as non-SNAP customers, with courtesy and respect. For example, do not require SNAP customers to make minimum purchases. Do not restrict SNAP customers to shopping at certain times. Do not use a separate register or lane for SNAP customers. These are program rules that you must follow at all times. Display the We Welcome SNAP EBT Customers poster. FNS will provide a We Welcome SNAP Customers poster and self-adhesive decal to you. Display the poster and decal in prominent places to let your customers know that you participate in SNAP. Report violations. FNS will also provide a Report Abusive SNAP poster to you. You must display this poster in a prominent place where people can easily see it. Always report suspected violations. What can be purchased using SNAP benefits? SNAP benefits are used to buy any food intended to be prepared and eaten at home. Generally, SNAP customers can use SNAP benefits to buy breads and cereals, vegetables and fruits, meat, poultry and fish, dairy products, and seeds and plants intended to grow food for their consumption. Cold, already prepared foods like deli sandwiches and salads are also eligible for purchase. If you have questions about specific food items, you can visit us online or consult the Retailer Service Center at 877-823-4369. What cannot be purchased using SNAP benefits? Ineligible items. SNAP benefits cannot be used to buy alcohol, tobacco, vitamins or medicines, pet foods, or non-food items such as tissue, soap, cosmetics, and other household goods. Also, foods that your store heats or cooks on-site before sale cannot be purchased with SNAP benefits. Bag fees. Some states charge customers a fee for each shopping bag provided by a grocery store. Shopping bag fees cannot be paid using SNAP benefits. These fees must be paid using another form of payment. If your store provides discounts to customers for bringing their own shopping bags, you must provide the same discount to SNAP customers. Sales tax. Generally, you cannot charge sales tax on food items that are purchased with SNAP benefits. Please review the retailer training guide for additional details. Contact your state's tax department if you have questions about sales tax laws. What else do I need to know? Bottle deposits. SNAP benefits can be used to purchase SNAP-eligible items in returnable bottles where the price includes a specific bottle deposit. This is true even if the deposit is not included in the shelf price. A deposit fee paid with SNAP benefits cannot exceed the state reimbursement amount. Contact your state government for information on the fee reimbursement limits in your state. Credit accounts. SNAP customers must pay for their purchases at the time that they receive their SNAP-eligible items. You must not accept SNAP benefits as payments on credit accounts. You must not hold your customers' EBT cards or SNAP account information for future use. Store coupons. If you accept coupons or offer discounts or incentives, you must do the same for SNAP customers. You must treat SNAP customers the same as non-SNAP customers. What happens if you break the rules? SNAP is a multi-billion dollar investment by American taxpayers. USDA protects that investment by enforcing program rules and aggressively prosecuting violators. Stores may be disqualified temporarily or permanently, fined for violating program rules, and can face criminal action. Once disqualified, FNS may disclose the store's name and address, owner's names, and the penalty. In general, trafficking is the official term for accepting SNAP benefits in exchange for cash. Buying or selling SNAP benefits for cash or purchasing food from a customer who has purchased the food elsewhere with their SNAP benefits may result in permanent disqualification, forfeiture of property, and a civil money penalty for each violation. Sale of ineligible items. Selling ineligible items on a regular basis for SNAP benefits may result in a 6-month to 3-year disqualification or equivalent civil money penalty. Sale of cigarettes, tobacco, and alcohol. Selling cigarettes, tobacco, alcohol, or non-food items for SNAP benefits may result in a 3 to 5 year disqualification or equivalent civil money penalty. A fiscal claim may also be assessed. Sale of firearms, ammunition, explosives, or controlled substances. Selling firearms, ammunition, explosives, or controlled substances for SNAP benefits will result in permanent disqualification and/or a civil money penalty for each violation. Accepting SNAP benefits without authorization. Accepting SNAP benefits without authorization or after your authorization has ended will result in a fine of $1,000 for each violation, plus an amount equal to 3 times the value of the illegally accepted SNAP benefits. Accepting SNAP benefits can be an important part of your business, but program violations are costly. Thank you for your interest in being a SNAP retailer. You can find additional information online at www.fns.usda.gov. The Retailer Service Center is also available to answer your questions at 877-823-4369.